Hey everybody, this is Dr. Michael Scherer talking a little bit of specific training here on locator angled, learning a little bit more up close the differences between our standard locator abutments as well as our locator angled abutments. Let's go ahead and dive right in. In front of us, I have a couple of models. I've got our standard locator implant models with existing locator abutments. And I also have here to the right-hand side of the screen our locator angled model, which has our standard locator abutments in the front as well as the locator angled in the back. Now, the first thing that we're going to look at when we take a look at these is they look awfully similar here. You can see here across the board, I have that characteristic kind of goldish color of the locator abutment. Plus, you can see here the distinctive triangle of the traditional locator abutment. And that'll be evident here between these four implants, which are the standard locator overdenture implants. And then my model over here on this side is going to be my locators here on the front here with sort of kind of these dummy implants. And then on the back, though, is going to be a little bit different. We can see the distinctive difference between where we have the triangle as well as the gold on the top. And now we have the gold with this kind of cylindrical cutout here in the center. And this is the new locator angled abutment. The locator versus the locator angled abutment, it's going to be looking like this. So this is my standard locator abutment. And when I take a look at it here, we'll see here that we've got that triangular appearance as well as the gold abutment. And then when I put that really side by side, right here I have my locator angled abutment, which has that distinctive gold color as well as the top portion that looks just like a locator abutment. It has a little cylindrical cutout here instead of the little triangle. And that cylindrical cutout allows me to go ahead and utilize an 050 hex driver to go ahead and place or to torque the abutment down. Additionally, this allows me to go ahead and utilize the same exterior geometry that we would have on our locator abutment. In addition, it also has this tiny little hole on the side of the abutment that's called the weep hole. That is the same between the locator and the locator angle. The external geometry of the abutment is exactly the same. The part that differs just ever so slight is going to be that internal geometry. And that's part of the reason why with locator angled, the locator angled system is compatible with extended range inserts as well as locator fixed inserts. It is not compatible with your blue, pink, and clear locator standard range inserts. And this is important because that little button that's on the inside of the standard range inserts is not compatible with the channel that's in the locator angled abutment. Now, coming back and taking a look at our models here, we have our standard inserts that I go ahead and I can take this and show this to a patient, say here's four implants. This is the scenario when you have perfect bone in the back of your jaw, no problem, snaps right on, nice stable denture. Here, try to remove this. Oh my gosh, that's really hard to remove. Wow, this is amazing. I said, but doctor, you told me I don't have bone for implants back here. So do you have another option? We do. Your option is locator angled. I can go ahead and tilt your implants in very creative fashions, utilizing special technology such as a 3D x-ray scan or a surgical guide to go ahead and allow me to go ahead and get a very precise angulation. Or for our surgical doctors that do this as a routine, pre-angling your implants 15 degrees allows your locator angled 15 degree abutment to go ahead and correct that 15 degrees of angulation correction. But with locator angled, we can go ahead and tilt those implants for up to 35 degrees of angulation because we get the extra 20 degrees of angulation correction with the extended range inserts, meaning 15 degrees of the abutment plus an additional 20 degrees of the extended range inserts for a locator. Looking at my model here, now we can see here that when I take this and show this to the patient, I have my standard range inserts here as well as my extended range inserts here on the back. Pops right on, gives you a very similar fit and feel as your other denture. However, now I can go ahead and simply tilt those implants to go ahead and avoid those areas where we don't have the bone or where there is some anatomy that we want to go ahead and stay away from. Now at this point here too, we can go ahead and place our standard locator abutments utilizing our locator core tool, or we can go ahead and use our manual driver to go ahead and place our locator abutments. With our locator angled, we are going to be using a hex driver to go ahead and tighten those down and to place our abutments in that orientation and angle. By doing so, I also have multiple positions of where I can position that locator angled abutment depending upon your implant system. So typically a lot of implant systems will come with a hex position, meaning you could have six possible positions of where you can angle your locator angled, versus your traditional locator only goes in one orientation. Any angulation that you would have to compensate for your original locator, your non-angled locator, is done by the housing as well as the insert. So your standard range inserts, you can correct up to the 20 degrees of total angulation correction, or 10 and 10 degrees between implants. And your extended range inserts with the original locator, you can go ahead and do up to a total of 40 degrees or 20 degrees between implants. With the locator angled, we can correct even more angulation than what we're used to by going ahead and combining the extended range inserts plus that pre-angled 15 degree abutment. Talk about incredible, especially for our surgical doctors that want to go ahead and angle utilizing implant placement in the anterior portion of the jaw, as well the mandibular arch to avoid the mental nerve or mandibular nerve, or the maxillary arch to go ahead and compensate for premaxillary angulation or maxillary sinuses. You can tilt those posterior implants and then correct the angulation with your locator angled above it. So this has been an up-close example of what locator angled looks like. This is Dr. Michael Scherer. Check out some of my additional training videos here at Zest and YouTube.